What would you call a setup like this? Hexaboot? Anyway, why would you ever want to do something like this? You wouldn't, but sometimes it's more interesting to test operating systems on a real computer as opposed to a virtual machine. And sometimes it's the only way, as is the case for the first copy of Windows XP we're gonna look at, the original equipment manufacturer copy, or in other words, what this computer would have originally come with. This is Windows XP Professional Service Pack 2 with additional pre-installed software from IBM and Lenovo. I've shown the restore process in another video, but what I didn't show is that back then I also did a system image backup of the hard drive. So for this experiment, I restored that instead of using all those CDs again. However, for some reason it wasn't booting up and it was stuck at a blank screen. But the recovery partition was restored successfully, so I used that to redo the restore process from the hard drive instead of from CDs, which was faster. Then it started up properly. This is the same OS I installed in that other video, but I changed the background picture to one with a world map I'm more familiar with. This picture wasn't included, I had to download it separately. Of course, this installation being designed for this computer, it comes with the appropriate drivers so we don't have to install those, even if they're outdated. Many of the included programs are also useful. Some of it is bloatware, like Google Desktop, Symantec Antivirus, and DiskKeeper Disk Defragmenter, but it's not too bad. In my upgrade journey video, I mentioned DiskKeeper, but I didn't show it, so here it is. It basically works the same as standard Windows Disk Defragmenter, except you can schedule automatic defragmenting, and they want you to buy the full version. It's odd how this clean installation has so many fragmented files. Maybe that's why it's so slow, but it's not worth defragmenting it for this video. As you know, Windows does not come with Office, but I wanted to try some extra programs. So on each copy of Windows, I installed Office 2003, the last version from the XP era. The second copy of XP I want to show is a standard one, without OEM customization or programs. If you know about Windows XP, you know about this one. This is what you would normally install if you wanted XP. In fact, not even the drivers are installed yet, so I should do that now before giving it a proper test. There are a lot of drivers to install, but to save time for this test, I'm just going to install the basic ones like chipset, video and audio. We're not connecting to any networks in this video. The OEM installation has a folder with all the drivers, so even if they're outdated drivers from 2005 or 2006, I can grab them from that disk partition and install them on the other copies of XP in this computer. Installing multiple drivers at the same time isn't a very good idea, but I did it anyway to install them quickly. Because it has much less stuff installed, it's gonna boot up a lot faster than the OEM installation. But if I cleaned up and defragmented the OEM installation, it would be similar. I don't know what this error about CLI.exe is. I've never actually seen it before. If I wanted to use this installation for anything serious, I'd have to install all the other drivers and some useful utilities like the ThinkManage Power Manager. Besides that, what is there to show? Here's Office 2003 that looks and works identically. Pretty much everyone knows how Windows XP works, and if you don't, there are several videos and web pages about it. This is one of the most influential operating systems ever made. Obsolete now, but never forgotten. Especially because we have time to look at more XP copies. We're now entering the area of dubious modifications of XP. You see, although Windows is not open source, it's possible to create a customized installation disk that installs an operating system that is the same at heart, but can come with different programs and themes in a radically different way compared to what an official OEM installation a computer comes with. Here's a peculiar one you might have already seen, called Gold Windows XP 2016, put together by a team from Pakistan. Unfortunately, I can't read Arabic, so I don't know what the boot screen says. But the rest of the OS is in English. The themes and programs included here are quite wacky, and some modifications are definitely dubious. Like, is that USB disk security really protecting my computer? But notice that it has the Windows Classic theme. That's because the special themes this operating system comes with can't be applied. My guess is that during the installation, it runs some programs to do the modifications. During the registering components phase, and or during the post-install phase. And these modifications are probably hard-coded to the C drive, but I was installing it on the E drive because this isn't the primary OS in this computer. One modification is probably the thing that allows unsigned themes. And there is also a custom hard drive icon which they set using an allaround.inf file. It was in the C drive, so I had to move them to the correct partition. And it overwrote my boot.ini file, so I had to edit it to specify the correct partitions for the different copies of XP. So if you really want to install Gold XP, you better make sure you install it as the first OS on the hard drive. But hey, it comes with Chicken Invaders, so it's totally worth it, right? Next is a French modification called WinLSD. I've shown it in another video, but this is a newer version which has Service Pack 3 instead of Service Pack 2. This one is focused on speed, so we'll see if that's true. When I was setting it up, it asked if I wanted to have the OS running in RAM and turn off the page file, and I told it yes. So this OS uses more RAM, but it should be faster. Well, I don't know, it doesn't seem much faster to me, and it still has those problems like Windows Update being turned off. It also comes with very little stuff, and for some reason the logon wallpaper became corrupted after installing the video driver, but I could fix it by changing the color depth from 16-bit to 32-bit. This is the most modern one, Windows XP Integral Edition from May 2020. It has all Windows XP and POS Ready 2009 updates, and a fork of Firefox that brings as many modern updates as possible. So that could be a safer option if you still have to use Windows XP regularly. Personally, I prefer updating a standard or OEM installation manually, but that takes longer. Windows Update is turned off, but it's pretty much fully up to date. And all Windows XP-based versions have lost support by now, so it's unlikely there will ever be any new updates. Still, turning it back on could be useful because some drivers are available on Windows Update. This also applies to Gold and WinLSD, but one thing I'm not a big fan of about these modified versions of Windows is that they remove most of the original content, like the wallpapers, screensavers, and programs. Part of the joy of using Windows XP is the aesthetic of it. Finally, this is the smallest version, Micro XP. This also has Service Pack 3, but it's been stripped down to the bare minimum. There is almost nothing on it, so it uses little disk space, it installs fast, and it runs fast, even faster than WinLSD. In fact, it's so stripped down it doesn't even have some system files that are required for the installation of the drivers. But I pointed it to the regular XP installation, and after lots of copying and pasting, it worked. Needless to say, updates can't be installed, but this OS could fit well on an offline embedded system if it weren't for the issue of piracy, or a tiny virtual machine that doesn't need to connect to a network. The README file says there are no exploits that updates could fix, but I'm not sure about that. How do these operating systems rank in my opinion? At 6th place, I would put WinLSD. It's really interesting, and you can practice French while using it, but I think some of the tweaks are a little bit too extreme. Of course, Windows isn't open source, but they modified some system files to try to make it faster, so many things break, like Windows updates, as I showed in my other video about this operating system. At 5th place, I would put Gold Edition. It actually has POS Ready updates enabled, and the thing is so ridiculous it's fun, but I wouldn't use it for anything serious because it could have hidden malware and pirated software. At 4th place I would put Micro XP because it's really lightweight, but of course that comes at a price. It's very limited, but some people may prefer that. At 3rd place I would put Integral Edition because it's fully updated, so you do a clean installation and it's fully up to date. At least as up-to-date as XP can be. The con is that it doesn't feel original, doesn't have the original pictures, screensavers, and programs, and so on. But if you don't care about that, you might want to consider this version of XP. At second place, I would put the OEM version. This is the version I would choose if I wanted to use XP on this computer because OEM versions are made specifically for your computer. They have all the drivers and maybe some other optimizations. The downside is that it may come with a lot of unnecessary programs, but you can just uninstall them. At first place, I would put the regular version of Windows XP. The upside is that this is the completely original version, how Microsoft wanted you to experience this operating system. The downside is that you have to install a lot of updates to be secure, and even then, this is not the most secure operating system these days. It's obvious that for anything serious, you should only use a proper operating system without dodgy unofficial modifications. But you certainly don't see a Hexaboot every day, and you definitely won't from me after I've wiped this test hard drive for the umpteenth time. By the way, I'm interested in your suggestions. So if you have any ideas for other operating system tests on a real computer, or anything else you'd like me to make a video about, let me know in a comment. Thank you for watching.